Duck waited at the platform with his passenger train. James was taking a long time. Peep, 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 whistled Duck. Where is that James? Why is it us branchline engines are on time and those big engines always take forever? At last, James appeared. He was short of steam and had to take on water. Duck was just about to steam away when a lady and her child jumped on the train a little too late. Hello, 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 said the guard. You can't just go jumping on and off trains like that. Why ever not, argued the lady. This train was about to leave and I did not want to be late. Oliver then arrived with his goods train. The child was very curious. He sneaked out of the carriage and walked towards Oliver's goods train. Oliver went to take on water and Toad was asleep. Now for some fun, thought the child, and scrambled aboard one of the wagons. By now, the lady and guard were arguing on the platform, when suddenly the woman shouted, "Where's my child?" She began looking frantically for him. At that moment, Oliver appeared, and took the goods train into the yard. "Hello, old chap," smiled Harold. "Looks like coal wagons again." "I'm afraid so," said Oliver. "On the bright side, I have some ballast wagons to take after this." "Goodbye," smiled Harold. "Carry on." "Look," shouted Oliver's driver. "There's something going on at the station." "What could that be?" wondered Oliver. By now, there was a crowd of people searching for the missing child. Oliver was surprised. "You don't think he managed to get into my train?" he asked the mother. She hopped on board him and they went back to the yard. The child had grown bored of the wagon and then noticed Harold. He giggled and crawled inside Harold's cockpit. The pilot saw him though. "Hello," he said. "Come for a ride, have you?" The child vigorously nodded and the pilot closed the door and set off, just as Oliver arrived. Suddenly the mother shouted, "My boy!" Oliver looked up and saw the child waving them from the cockpit window. "Quick," said the guard, "get in the brake van and we can get a move on." "Give chase, Oliver," said the woman. "We must flag them down somehow." Oliver shot through the station at a tremendous speed and gave poor Duck a fright. The child laughed. He thought Oliver was trying to play. He waved at them again. "My baby!" called the woman. "Don't worry," soothed his driver. "Oliver can beat them to the next station, can't you, boy?" "I'll give it a good try," said Oliver as he roared along. Toad was the only one who wasn't focusing on the child.
Do we have to go so fast, Mr. Oliver?" asked Toad.
Oliver paid no attention. He surged forward, flying through Lower Tidmouth. At last, he arrived at the top station. Harold then landed.
"It's a good thing I chased you down," said Harold. "This child needed her mother back."
"You? Just...
Us? Spluttered Oliver. The mother was reunited with her child. Oliver was happy that they were back together, but he was still furious.
He chased us, he wheezed. Why, that is the most ridiculous thing I've heard in all my years of running on rails.
Harold laughed and took off. That night, the station master came up to Oliver. The woman wrote a letter to us, he smiled, and she agrees with me that you are a really useful engine.